And there was some excitement last night in the Pacific Northwest on the Pro-Am circuit as the Hype Brothers made their debut at Seattle Pacific. Stephen A. Smith, what'd you think of the performance?
What I want to really say is that, first of all, it was about time. It's nice to know that the brothers listened to me, because I was the one talking about how they needed to play together. They accepted the counseling that I provided.
Yes, you did.
Now they are out on the court again, handling their business. Nick Howard looked pretty good. The comeback kid truly looked like the comeback kid. Seems like he's completely healed from that ACL injury. I like what I saw. I was very impressed. And more importantly, I want to applaud their intellect, listening to the wisdom that I espoused. They deserve a lot of credit.
You just love taking this bow, don't you? And look, I'm not taking any credit away from them, or for you for that matter.
Okay.
But shouldn't we contextualize this a little bit? It was a very impressive performance, there's no denying it. But it is one game, and how shall I say this? I think we need to be cautious about overstating the level of competition here.
Well, there's no doubt about that, but at the same time, it's whether or not they're taking the proper steps towards prosperity. Bottom line is they did step one. Now, step two, I'm hearing they're going to show up in the Dykeman League. We're hearing that they're going to show up and perform there. We'll see how they do in that particular situation, but the hype is real because people who have watched them over the years are seeing similarities now to what they saw back then, and that's the most important
point. Believe the hype?
I'm not saying believe the hype. I'm not saying don't believe the hype. I'm simply saying don't poo-poo anything right now. Let's wait and see.
Are you accusing me of poo-pooing?
Possibly. Quite possibly.
I may have
poo-pooed. You are negative, Max.
I may have poo-pooed a little bit.
Maybe.
Right, bro. 4 a.m., I'm just getting started. For my birthday, I threw me a surprise party. Reminiscing about the playing the first quarter. My life changed when I had my first daughter. Got my first quarter flipping $50. You looking at the bills, asking you for half. Cut from a different cloth. Take pride in results. Anytime you want it, I'm providing the sauce. You on side of the boss, so you kind of the boss.
Sun shines brightly over the high court of Uptown Hoop Dreams, precariously divided between Washington Heights and Inwood. Between the whistles and beneath the project towers is where a young Luau Cinder changed from a boy to the prototypical big man, perfecting the skyhook and agility unprecedented. Part and parcel of a history fathoms deep, where 3,000 highlight-hungry fanatics crowd the fence weekly to bear witness to the greatness of guards like Eric Opio, AKA El Presidente, disrupting any and all defenses. J.R. Smith and Kemba Walker perfecting their seasonal alley-oops and step-backs. Dominican Power raining long-range crossover dreams on Uptown's friendliest rims. Young men with names like Too Hard to Guard, formerly known as Idris De Leon, before his handle made him the stuff of legend, New York City's Black Top Kingdom. Many would say this is the most entertaining outdoor ball in the city. Between the lines and in the paint, and with a style and grace that can only be found uptown. We are New York City basketball at its very best. Dykeman. play of the game.